I'm Catherine Hill. I'm a medical entomologist and I work for Purdue University.
And I'm John McDonald. I'm a retired medical entomologist at Purdue University.
We are out here in a city park today doing some surveillance for mosquitoes. We're looking for the mosquitoes that might potentially transmit West Nile virus. West Nile virus is found all over the United States. It's a virus that's transmitted by a mosquito. The mosquitoes can be found in lots of different places. They typically breed in containers like buckets, dog bowls, tins and cans. They can also be found in natural areas like this where we have some standing water. We come out to sites like this one and we're looking for the larvae that will grow up into the adult mosquito, and we're also looking for the adult mosquito. And we use the information that we collect at field sites to help us with control of mosquitoes, and we also use that to find out whether the mosquitoes are potentially infected with the virus, and then we use that information to develop information for the general public to help them protect themselves from West Nile virus.
We go out into the field and we try to find places such as this, and then we do a routine technique such as dipping into the water so that we can look for the immature stages of the mosquitoes. And then we take a dipper like this and collect the mosquito larvae live, and then go back to the lab and kill them. And then we identify them to species and try to get information on the immature stages of the species that are carriers of the West Nile virus.
The female mosquito, the Culex mosquito that transmits West Nile virus, is attracted to smelly standing water, really foul, stinky, smelly water.
P.U., you stink!
What we were doing there was using something called a gravitrap. It has smelly water in the bottom in a bucket and then a fan to attract the female mosquitoes up into a net. And so that's the way that we collect the female mosquito. And then when we've got them, we take them back into the lab to identify them and test them for West Nile virus. One of the really interesting things is that West Nile virus is maintained in birds, and it's acquired by a mosquito when it feeds on the bird, and then when the mosquito takes a second blood meal and bites a human, it can transmit the West Nile virus to a human. One of the important things to understand about the mosquitoes that transmit West Nile virus is that they don't fly very far from where they develop. And that's why it's important to sample in places like parks and urban areas where people might come into contact with those mosquitoes and potentially get West Nile virus. The first thing that's really important to think about is if you're going to be in an area where you might come into contact with the mosquito that could transmit West Nile virus, is to wear a repellent or to wear clothing that would help prevent you from getting bitten by mosquitoes. And the other thing is to, if you can, avoid being outdoors at times when mosquitoes might be biting, which is generally around dusk. But the other thing to remember is that not every mosquito out there is the type of mosquito that can transmit West Nile virus. And not all of those mosquitoes are actually infected with West Nile virus. So the risk is fairly low of getting infected with West Nile virus. But regardless, it is a serious disease and you don't want to catch it. So it's important to take precautions not to get the disease. Was just sort of born that way. I just grew up loving bugs right from an early age. I just was fascinated by insects, and I liked to be out in the yard collecting insects, collecting caterpillars. And it used to drive my mother insane because I'd collect all of these insects and bring them back into the house. So it just was there. It was something I was always interested in. But I was really fortunate along the way to have some excellent teachers, and I did some work experience at a university with some entomologists when I was going through high school. And that's where I discovered that there was a profession in entomology. And then a little later on, I was really interested in medicine. I was interested in human health, but I didn't want to do medicine. And I realized that I could combine my interest in entomology with medicine by becoming a medical entomologist.
Well, I didn't get interested in insects until I was probably a junior in college, and the only reason I got involved with insects at all is that that was the only course that was open in the summer school that I had to go to. And so I was not a traditional person that liked insects as I grew up. But the single most important event that got me involved with insects was the professor from whom I took that course in summer school was wonderful. He got me involved with insects, and he also got me a job at a mosquito research field station, and I worked there for 2 years. And I was fully intending up until that time to be a professional baseball player, but I couldn't hit a fastball, so I knew I had to go into something else.
But I'd like to tell the kids watching this video that if you're interested in something, follow what you love, and that's what you'll be best at, and that's what you do really well at. So do what you love to do.